I hope you guys are ready, because it's adventure time. The tide is at its lowest, which is the perfect opportunity to search for marine creatures.
Nothing takes Bizarr to the extreme like tide pools.
And beneath the surface, a kingdom of animals that are seldom encountered.
That is perfect tide pooling area. I see some pockets right there filled with eelgrass. See some kelp down in there. This is gonna be perfect.
Come on, lucky rock. Whoa!
Look at this. It is a huge prickleback.
Wow, that is the biggest one I've ever seen. And see those distinct stripes?
I do.
That's how I was able to identify it as a rock prickleback. And here's something really cool about these pricklebacks. They can actually breathe air. They breathe underwater with their gills, and then when the tide goes out, they can stay out of the water for several hours breathing air.
Oh, whoa, Mark, check this out.
Wow, that feels crazy, like a big leech on my hand.
Looks like I have webbed fingers.
Now you can eat kelp, some people do, but if you were here and you stuck your face in this and you could smell it, it's like a rotten fish market. Woo, this is awesome. Oh my gosh, there's an octopus. This is the common octopus. They can get bigger than this, but to be honest with you guys, this is the largest octopus I have ever caught, and it is on the move. The only reason you'd ever find an octopus out of water is if it's moving from tide pool to tide pool. As that tide recedes, the octopus, if it's not in a deep enough pocket, will oftentimes try to find itself back out into the ocean currents. Oh, look at that right there.
I got him. Look at that. There it is. That is the purple shore crab.
And you notice how that crab is blowing bubbles? He's not doing that to be funny. He's actually doing it to aerate his gills. And if you didn't know that crabs have gills, they do. All these little bubbles, because he's out of the water right now, as they pop, push oxygen back in through his gills. If you were ever to go out into the tide pools and try to catch one of these crabs and you are pinched like this, don't panic. Try to tough through the pain and gently set it back down into the water. Watch this. As soon as he's down there, he will let go of my finger. Whoa, look at its colors. It's so bright. What, have you ever seen a sea star that big before? It is a purple sea star, and this is one of the largest species that you can find off the Pacific coast. You see all these little white things that look like spaghetti noodles? Those are called tube feet. Now, they have thousands of these, and they're used to slowly move over the surface of rocks when they're underwater. Oh, look at this. That's called a sea lemon. Now, I can see it's got its little sensory organs out, and see that little frilly cluster in the back there?
Mm-hmm.
Those receptors help them sense chemicals in the environment, and that's how these creatures move about. Not all lemons are sea lemons, but all sea lemons live in the sea. Try saying that 10 times fast. Let's head down the beach and see what else we can find. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave, stay wild. We'll see you on the next adventure.